Welcome to Ultimate Driver. This is a video for my guys who have got their test coming up, just to help them remember the different manoeuvres. This video is about the turn in the road, or also known as three-point turn. So just before we shoot off, let's just look at a couple of things. I'm looking ahead, so I get an idea of how steep it might be as I approach the curb on the right, or especially when I'm approaching the curb on my way back on the left side of the road here. Just trying to gauge, you know, if the car might roll forwards or backwards, depending on how steep the camber is going into the curb. So I've had a bit of a look at that, and it's not too bad at this particular point. There's a little bit more on the left side of the road than the right. So in preparation, I'm going to prepare the car and get ready. So in the particular car I'm using today, I'm out in the Mini Cooper S, won't be using any gas, just using really good clutch control. So I'll start by, I'm going to have a good look around, starting over my left shoulder, looking out the back window, scanning all around through the side windows, through my left mirror, up the curb. I'm looking straight up the head of the road now, which is where the camera's pointing. Looking at the curb on the right-hand side, checking my right mirror, right through to my blind spot. Quite happy that the road's completely safe, there's no one there. So I've got my driving point set on the clutch. The handbrake's down, I'm just slowly moving away from the curb, and I've already got all my steering on. So I'm just slowly approaching the curb on the right-hand side of the road now. And I'm just waiting until my reference point comes in under the mirror so I can see a little bit of the path and the curb under my right-hand mirror now. Handbrake on, that's the first part finished. I'm gonna prepare the car in reverse now. Just making sure the clutch is not too high so the car doesn't jump backwards, but making sure that the clutch isn't too low that my car's gonna roll forwards towards the curb. It's important that I don't overhang the curb at the front, and it's obviously very important that my wheels don't touch the curb also. So very important when you're carrying this maneuver. As I go to the reverse phase, the car's prepared. I've got a really good clutch setting now. Looking over my blind spot, scanning right through the car now, over my left shoulder, out the back window. I'm gonna continue looking out the back window whilst I travel halfway across the road. So I'm off now. I'm driving the car as slowly as I can, and I'm turning the steering wheel as fast as I can. I'm still looking out the back window. I'm about halfway now, so I'm gonna switch my vision, turning my head right round over my right shoulder. So I'm now looking through my blind spot and I'm looking for my reference point to stop. And it's just when the curb line on my right hand side appears in the bottom corner of my window, and that's there now. Handbrake on, that's the second phase complete. I'm into first gear, I'm finding my driving point now, looking over the left, scanning right through to the right, it's all clear, making sure I've got just the right clutch setting, easing the handbrake off gently just so I can measure, making sure the car's not going to roll back. The car's moving forward nicely, so I'm steering as quickly as I can to the right now, and I'm done. Okay, we're going to take a look now at the steering method for turning the road. So if you've been driving with me already, this steering technique I'm about to use will just seem completely normal. Just waiting for a car to come past me. There it goes. So I'll have the car prepared, ready to go. I've carried out my observations now. My right hand's starting at the top of the steering wheel because I'm turning to the right. So once I'm ready to go, and you'll notice within just being a few centimeters away from the curb, all my steering will be on. So I'll be generating the tightest arc I can traveling to the other side of the road. So off we go, watching the hands. One, two, that's it, I'm done. I've barely left the curbside and the maximum steering on the steering wheel now. Looking for the curb to come in under the mirror. There it is. Handbrake on and I'm done. Into reverse. Watching the steering again now. So I'm steering to the left this time. So my left hand will be starting at the top. Securing the steering wheel with my right hand as the handbrake goes down. Left hand at the top. The car's just moving off now. One and two and I'm done. So I've only just a few centimeters off the curb and the maximum amount of steering's on. And then to pull away again into first gear, finding a good driving point. Not too high that I go too fast, and not too low that I roll backwards. Right hand at the top now because I'm steering to the right, easing the handbrake down. One, two, and I'm done. Using this method will allow you to complete a turn in the road maneuver in narrower roads than you would think usually you'd be able to. Even when it comes to your driving test, it doesn't matter if it takes you 3-point or a 5-point or even a 7-point turn. So long as Your observations are completely up to scratch while you're doing it. That means each time you're driving forwards or reversing, you're checking your observations first. And when you're reversing, you must be looking out the back window of the car, especially when you begin. Just remember, when it comes to your driving test, its observations are the most important thing here for you to carry out. If you don't quite get as close to the curb as you should, or you're maybe just a few centimeters too close and the car's slightly overhanging, and the same when you're doing the reverse, well, just remember for a moment that the examiners do have some leeway. They're probably not going to let you off when it comes to things like observations and safety. What they really want you to do here, or what they really want you to show them, is that you can turn the car around safely without hitting anything or anyone. So when you're reversing, you can't really look in your mirrors because they won't show you as much as if you've turned your head over your left shoulder and you're looking out the back window and then you're changing halfway through to check over your shoulder. Because the car's at an angle to the curb, your interior mirror will only show you what's directly behind the car. It won't show you what's to the left and right of the car. And that's why it's really important you don't rely on your mirrors through the reverse part of turning the road. You must look over your shoulders.